Good morning everyone. In Nursing Foundation, till now we discuss about the overview of machinery, equipment and linen. In previous classes, we discussed briefly and how to care the glassware, rubber goods and stainless steel instruments, care of linen. And today, just I recall the topic once. Equipment is defined as it is empowered equipment intended for using treatment, diagnosis, monitoring and life sustaining or resuscitating functions. Examples of these equipments are defibrillators, patient monitors, infusion devices and patient imaging equipment, beds, cots, bedside lockers, bedside tables, chairs, stools and all these under hospital or machinery equipments. And next, care of stainless steel equipments. Under stainless steel equipments, forceps, needles, scopes, sharp instruments, miscellaneous. In forceps, artery forceps, sponge holding, chital forceps. In needles, intramuscular injection, intravenous, subcutaneous injections or biopsy needles, liver or lung biopsy and laryngoscope, surgical blades, knives, scissors, these are all under stainless steel instruments. What are they? Forceps, needles, instruments, miscellaneous. And how to care it? Stainless steel items are heat resistant, anti-corrosive in nature and long-lasting but expensive. Don't boil directly. It's sterilized by using chemicals or autoclaving method. Always we use gloves while cleaning. And after cleaning, dry instruments properly. Knife and scissors are handled with care because they are sharp instruments. They are sterilized by hot air sterilizer, exposing into temperature of 160 degrees Celsius for an hour. Chemical disinfectants can be done by pure Dettol. And how to clean stainless steel instruments? After use, we must wash the instruments under cold running water, and after that, immerse in 0.5% chlorine solution and 2% glutaraldehyde for 20 to 30 minutes. Remove from disinfectant, rinse in sterile water stream. And after remove that all stains, we must wipe it with dry. Store in appropriate container. This is how to clean that stainless steel instruments. First one, wash the instruments in cold running water. And next one, immerse in 0.5% chlorine solution for 20 to 30 minutes. And after that, we must rinse with disinfectant solution. After dry and store in appropriate container. And this is about stainless steel equipments, forceps, needles, instruments and miscellaneous. After that, care of needles. How to care the needles? If used needles are there, we must flush it with 0.5% chlorine and destroy the needle with needle destructor. After that, dry pack and send needles for autoclaving for sterilization. And after that, and some OT instruments, and these are surgical blades and spatulas, forceps. These are all under stainless steel instruments. And other instruments are there. Before sending, we must check the instruments whether it is cleaned or not. And this is autoclave is the best method of sterilization. And after that, care of linen. Care of linen. Linens are clean linen, contaminated linen and soiled linen. Clean linen means the linen which are not used. Contaminated means it will be used in already. It is used. And after that, soiled means the linens which are in laundry, they are called them as soiled linen. Dirty linen should not be sent into laundry. and after that carefully sorted, stock taking and recorded. Linen management plays a great role in patient satisfaction and reduces infection rate, and it plays an important role in physician satisfaction. And if delay in time becomes a good support towards delivering timely quality healthcare services to the patients. If the hospital does not have proper supply chain of linen, then this will be lead to delay in OT operations or ICU procedures. Patient care services, delay in CSSD operations. So the patient, the hospital or a nurse should must be alert to clean that linen, okay, and send to into laundry for immediately. After that, care of rubber goods. In rubber goods, air cushions, Macintosh, hot water bottles, ice caps, ice collars, rubber tubes, catheters, gloves, these are all under care of rubber goods. In rubber goods, these are all under catheters, rectal tubes, gloves, rubber red, rubber tubes, ice caps, hot water bottles, Macintosh, air cushion. They should be purchased only after nature and durability have been investigated. The nurse should make all efforts to prolong the life of the rubber goods. The main responsible is nurse. What is the purpose to care the rubber goods? To prevent spread of infection, to clean the article and prepare for reuse, to remove stains, to preserve life of articles. And after that, what are the principles to care the rubber articles? Rubber goods get destroyed with heat. Do not use hot water to clean, sunlight for drying, or keep near radiator. Okay, do not fold rubber sheets. That example, Macintosh, do not fold. Do not stick pins on rubber goods, and store rubber goods in wood cupboards. Always dry rubber goods after cleaning them in a shade, as heat destroys them. Do not use clamps for longer periods. And time period of the use of a hot water bottle and heater flow pads, ice collar caps should not be used more than 15 to 20 minutes. And after that, care of glassware items. In glassware items, thermometer is one of the glassware item. We must clean the thermometer with a disinfectant solution. It should be cleansed with a smooth surface to avoid abrasions and erosions. Should be sterilized with dry heat. After use, flush with cold water, again wash it with warm water, sterilize it for 10 to 20 minutes. And after that, care of enamel ware. Bedpans, under enamel ware, bedpans, urinals, and this is bedpan, and this is urinal, enamel kidney tray, sputum cup. Okay, the articles commonly used are bedpans, urinals, kidney trays and sputum cups. What are the principles to handle this enamel ware? Avoid mishandling. Don't boil them longer periods. It should be empty to a lavatory pan. Don't throw outside in mud or any dumped area. We must throw in lavatory pan. Rinse the articles with cold water and then use any cleaning agent to remove stains. Wash with soap or warm water by using brush. By using brush, we must wash that bedpan or urinals or kidney trays, sputum cups with warm water or soap by using brush. and after that disinfect the articles, soak them in 1:40 for 1 hour. For 1 hour we must soak the bedpan or urinals or sputum cup in disinfectant solution, and after that place it directly in sunlight, keep them dry. Should not be left standing for a long time with urine. The urinals should not be left standing for a long time with urine because they get odor and some germs inside. And after that, hospital furniture. In hospital furniture, medication carts, tables, chairs, rooms, couches, shelters, these are all cleaned with disinfectant solution or sanitized twice a day. We must clean. And after that, indent. What is indent? Indent is an official order or requisition for medicine and supplies from the medical stores. Equipment stored safely. And after that, inventory. What is meant by inventory? Inventory control. Detailed list of articles in the ward. What are the articles in the ward? There must be list out. It meant making a count of articles in hand. And there are some methods of inventory control. They are visual method, ABC analysis, VAD classification, and two-bin system. What is visual? What is visual control method? In visual control method, it is the simplest way and what you have on hand and decide what to get. Okay. And ABC, next one, ABC analysis. Always better control. How many materials consume and how much it cost, we must assess. And after that, VAD classification. VAD classification means vital, essential, desirable. Vital, essential, desirable. And after, two bin system. Main bin and a backup bin of products. Will the products from the main bin first before using the backup bin indent for the product. And this is the methods of inventory control. Visual control method, ABC analysis, VAD classification, and two bin system. And after that, sterilization techniques. These all equipments under sterilization only. We must clean the equipments under sterilization, autoclave method or hot air oven or natural method or chemical, physical, and radiation methods. That's why we must know about the sterilization. What is the importance of sterilization and purpose and definition methods we must know. What is sterilization? Sterilization is the process by which an object becomes free from all microorganisms. By sterilization, pathogenic organisms are destroyed. What is the purpose? To render articles free from pathogens and to destruction of microorganisms, to sterilize instruments and equipments used in the surgical practice, to keep the articles in such a condition that they are ready for use at any time for the safety of the patients. And after that, methods. In natural method, physical method, chemical method, radiation method. In physical method, there are two types. What are those? Boiling, hot air oven, and autoclaving. You know already about that, autoclaving and hot air oven. And after that, chemical method of sterilization. There may be by using disinfectants. By using disinfectants, which acts by coagulating the bacterial protein or by changing the composition of protein so that it is no longer exist in the same form. And this is chemical method. And after that, radiation method means if the plastic items and disposable saline sets, catheters, Rayleigh tubes, disposable syringes are nowadays, this radiation method will be used for these items. These things or ultraviolet light sterilization. And this is about sterilization techniques. Okay. And machinery equipment and linen chapter is completed. Once go through it, and make a knot. Once you read this chapter, so you it's better to understand deep briefly. Thank you everyone.